In unserem vorherigen Talk haben wir schon ein bisschen Einblick erhalten, was denn so an Technologie da.
So in the talk before, we heard about the technology which is available to protect our borders, and now we are going to hear a talk about how the status for the refugees and for the people who are helping the refugees in the Mediterranean. So please welcome our speakers.
Wir begrüßen euch zu unserer Präsentation über die europäischen Außen.
Welcome to our presentation about the European outer borders. We want to give an overview about the routes refugees are taking to Europe and about the what happens this year regarding this. We are talking about the policies regarding the frontiers, and Nico and myself, we have been in the Mediterranean helping the refugees there, and we are going to talk about our experience. We are going to talk about the borders at sea, and these borders at the sea and our work is just a small part about the whole situation. There's a lot of other work which is done by other organizations, and which is just as important. And we encourage you to inform yourself about all the other work which is going on, even though media is focusing on the borders at sea a lot. So thank you for the introduction. We have brought you a map. And when we are talking about the Mediterranean, which lines for refuge are there? There are mainly three routes. One is very much to the west from Morocco to Spain, around Gibraltar. The second important route is to the central Mediterranean from Libya in direction to Italy. And the third one is is the eastern one from Turkey, from the Turkish mainland to the Greek islands. So I want to make clear that we made a sharp distinction, but there is no real huge distinction between them. And over time, the routes change a lot regarding how many people are taking which routes and also where exactly it is geographically. So historically, we can say fleeing from over the Mediterranean, that's not a new phenomenon. We are seeing this since the 90s. In the beginning of the 90s, mainly in Western Africa. One moment. In the beginning of the 90s, it was mainly in West Africa to the Canary Islands, and in the beginning of the zero years, it's more towards the center of the Mediterranean. Excuse me.
Genau. Also, es verlagert sich in das Mittelmeer selber hinein.
So it's more going towards the central Mediterranean, and we need to be clear.
Ich muss mich mal kurz hinsetzen. Entschuldigung.
Excuse me, I need to take a seat for a moment. Okay, I'm going to continue with my part, which is also very interesting. And then we are going back to Nico once he's feeling better. I want to talk about the Libyan Coast Guard, which we can see on this picture. The so-called Libyan Coast Guards is a militia which is founded mainly by Europe, mainly by Italy, to violate human rights. An explanation. There is a war going on in Libya. There is no proper government in Libya. And the EU is saying that the official government has only limited influence about the military and the militia which is active in Libya. And so these Coast Guards are part of this militia, but there is also a lot of infighting going on. They give themselves the name themselves Libyan Coast Guard as a like umbrella term, and they are funded by the Italian government to save lives. But in reality, the Libyan Coast Guard is forcing the humans onto their boats, is leaving people dying on the Mediterranean, on the sea, if they don't want to go back to Libya. And there have been documented cases where the Libyan Coast Guard was not willing to rescue refugees dying in the Mediterranean. Just as well, we have heard reports from refugees jumping back into the sea to not be brought back to Libya. At the same time, the Libyan Coast Guard is fighting other organizations trying to save refugees. That there is a civil war going on in Libya leads to the fact that there is no safe harbors in Libya where people in need can be brought back to from international waters. Human rights watchers have described the places in Libya very badly. There are people being beaten and raped and so on. And these practices are being enforced. This year, the Italian government has renewed a pact from Italy to where Italy is supporting Libya, saying they want to make Libya a safe country for refugees, which obviously is horrible and against every human right. Here a small presentation. You can see in the central Mediterranean in compared 2017 to 2018 through this installment of the so-called Libyan Coast Guard, the people arriving have been gone down a lot. This is not the case because there is a lot of people trying to get there, but because a lot of people are being caught in international waters and are transported back illegally to Libya. 2,242 humans have died in the Mediterranean within this year. This number alone is saying a lot about the politics regarding the European outer borders. None of these people should have been died. One question. Why are people fleeing by boat to Europe? There is a simple answer. For most of them, there is no other option for escape towards Europe. This way is very expensive. They would need official documentations, official certificates, which aren't available because there is wars going on and so on. If you apply for a visa, it takes a lot of time. It's impossible to wait for all this time, and also it is again very expensive for people coming from a country where there's war or who are in danger of violence. So the only way to get to a safe country is a so-called illegal way of escape. So you're crossing a border without a legal or acknowledged passport. In theory, everyone would have a right to asylum once you have reached the European mainland or are in European waters. But in reality, the time to get an official asylum takes a long time. They are living in uncertainty. They basically can't develop an independent life. They aren't able to decide independently where they want to live. During this time period, it's basically impossible to work on your traumas, and traumata are being reinforced by the surrounding in which they are kind of imprisoned. And arriving the European mainland and getting asylum doesn't mean safety. There is a lot of cases where the right to asylum is not recognized, and people are being deported without really being registered. Here you see a picture of the life jacket graveyard. Each of these life vests has been worn by one person crossing the Mediterranean. In the European Parliament, there is no outcry when people are dying, because those people are no longer a hassle for Europe, so they don't have to be registered. For Europe, it's fine if these people are dying, because otherwise they would stop it. Through the public demand, it becomes normal and even as a wanted situation that the people fleeing from war, from violence, are denied human rights. This is not a natural disaster. This is human-made. And it's the politically thought this way.
It's not important why a person flees. Violence, war, hunger, or no perspectives. Every human has a right to find security and future. Nico's back.
So, ich bin wieder da, noch kurz im Ausfall. Versuchen wir einfach dort weiterzumachen, wo wir vorhin unterbrochen haben.
He'll try continuing where he stopped. In the beginning of the 90s, the escapes over the Mediterranean started. In the start of the noughties, this went into the middle of the Mediterranean, where certain geopolitical factors influenced this. For example, the fall of Gaddafi and the destabilization of Libya, which made this possible, as well as the Syrian civil war, where people are using the eastern route, but also political alliances like the EU-Turkey deal, which is trying to block the eastern Mediterranean route. To come back to the central Mediterranean, the main part of the tragedy has happened here, and the year 2013, it's very extraordinary. There were a lot of ship disasters, a lot of news about that, until October 2013, where two ship disasters came right after the other, on the end of Lampedusa. Over 500 people died. That was the last waking call, which made Italy send out a Sea Watch mission. People knew that under Mare Nostrum, with Italian military ships and Coast Guard ships, with the goal of saving people. This mission was there till October 2014, was pretty successful, saved a lot of people. deutlich zurückgegangen ist. The death rate shrank in this time, but after this 1 year, Italy was still doing this alone. No other European country cooperated financially nor by taking in the refugees. For these reasons, Italy stopped this mission in 2014, and there was a huge gap left behind because people were still coming, but there were no sea coast guard ships. This gap was closed by a civilian sea watch organization. The idea was, if states can do this to save people, if the rich Europe can do this, we as a civil society have to do it ourselves. We can't let people die before our continent. And the civil sea watch, starting 2015, was very turbulent in the last years with highs and lows. We'll try to give a view back on the year 2018. There were news here and there, but what was left at the end of the year, and I noticed myself while I'm really following this topic, when looking back, I noticed that a lot of these points were already gone from my memory, because just so many. And looking forward, we could also see in August of 2017, Italy seized the Juventa, saving ship, and they took the first civilian Coast Guard ships out of service. In March 2018, the Open Arms was seized in Italy, and luckily these could get free after 1 month. A thing we can see in the whole year is in June, the Aquarius saved, together with other ships, 600 people, and everyone went on board of Aquarius, and they would like just drive to a harbor and bring the people at the land, but this didn't happen. There was no harbor assigned to them, so the Aquarius was on the Mediterranean for 3 days, not knowing where to go. And afterwards, Spain said they would take in these people. And so the Aquarius and two other ships, a European military ship and an Italian Coast Guard ship, which carried the people, they drove for 5 days on from the central Mediterranean to Spain to bring these people on land in Valencia. But at the same time, the Italian Coast Guard ship Dicotti had a similar case. They saved people, and as an Italian Coast Guard ship, they didn't get in harbor in Italy, which was due to the big political pressure in Italy and other places. And they were on the sea for days as well. The end of this was in the end of July, when the Lifeline, which saved 150 people, was also stranded at sea for a week on the Mediterranean, which is far smaller ship than the other two, until European countries were okay with taking in people. And the ship was allowed to land in Malta, but it was seized at once, and the captain was confronted with criminal charges, and the ship is still in Malta and is not allowed to drive out. This principle came up again a few days later, at the beginning of July, when the Sea Watch wanted to drive out for the saving mission, and they were not allowed as well. This principle of not letting ships drive out was a European strategy and tactics the tactic that you don't want that ships are there to save people that Europe has to take in. So you want even less to have ships that can document people dying and to kill off this witnessing thing. Malta grounded the civilian observation plane Seabird, so they weren't able to document what the Libyan Coast Guard, what people in danger experienced. In reaction to that, there was a big answer of the civil society, which said, we can't look at this much longer. They started the Sea Bridge movement, which got pretty big, had a big demonstration at the 7th of July in Berlin. The humans protested for Sea-Watch and secure harbors.
In the beginning of August, we had a new low point when another ship, an Italian ship, was rescuing people from the Mediterranean and brought them right back to Libya. All in all, we have seen the situation quite a lot, especially by the Libyan Coast Guard. Why is this new? Well, because it's a European ship which brought the people back to Libya. There was a similar case in 2009 where people were rescued and brought back by Libyan boats. The people went to court about this in the European court, and there was they agreed that it is inhuman to bring people back to Libya into a civil war. So now this is incredible that people, like ships from European countries, from Italy, are bringing people back to Libya. And the tactic to bring to not allow ships to go out, Europe has also decided for another way to go. So Gibraltar wanted to remove the flag from a ship which was at sea. The official reason was the reason given was that the ship was registered as a survey vessel, but we are seeing that it is doing search and rescue missions. But interestingly, there isn't even a category where you could register a ship as a rescue vessel. So additionally, we have to say that for all the years the ship was registered in Gibraltar, there were no other issues which would allow to remove the flag from the ship. The Italian ship, the Coty, which we have mentioned before, also again was in the news end of August when there were 190 people on board and they were in harbor in Catania, and there they weren't allowed to leave the people go to the land, which resulted in Italy bringing to court stuff against the inner minister of Italy for jailing people when he gave a speech in response where he basically quoted Mussolini. So after 10 years on board, the people were finally allowed to leave the ship to go on land and get medical help. The Aquarius flags was removed, and because there are still rescue missions which need to be done, they tried to get a new flag, and they finally got it in September and went back to a rescue mission with a flag from Panama. And 1 week later, the flag was again removed by Panama because of the pressure by Italy towards Panama. Italy was saying, if you don't remove the flag from the Aquarius, we are not going to accept ships from Panama in our harbors. And so Panama was under a lot of pressure, so they decided to remove the flag. In the meantime, there was some good news. After 3.5 years, the Sea-Watch 3 was allowed to leave Malta and is again on a mission since the end of November. And then some more bad news. So Mediterranee, the organization operating the Aquarius, announced that they will stop doing their rescue missions after 2,000 people saved and after years of work, because they are no longer capable of finding a flag to go out under, to find a country giving out their flag to do those rescue missions. In other news this year, 75 people were rescued by a transport ship and were brought back to Libya. The people refused to go off board, and after 1 week on board, the military removed them by force. Additionally, another ship from a place, a European country, Libya. Sorry, I didn't catch this. The military operation in the meantime cancelled their rescue missions because they also didn't get any harbors where they could go into. And a German newspaper, a quality newspaper, wanted to discuss whether rescue missions in the Mediterranean should be allowed, and the internet gave an adequate response to this.
By saying that maybe the voluntary firefighters shouldn't save people as well.
So just right now, the Sea-Watch 3 has 33 people on board, and they have saved them a couple days ago, and they again didn't get a safe harbor to go to.
Während die Staaten Europa versucht, die Schiffe selber außen vor zu halten.
While the European states try to criminalize the immigrants and refugees, and there is another way they want to go, and now they are targeting the helpers and the people who are showing solidarity and don't look away. There is a crew of the Inventa, a ship which has been captivated since middle of 2017. So now we know that people are being charged because they helped people, quote, illegally immigrate into Italy. And that's a hard charge, like a very big charge in Italy. There's a lot of money and up to 5 years in prison. We can draw parallels to Cap Anamur, a ship in 2004, which rescued refugees in the Mediterranean and brought them to Italy. Back in that day, the captain and other crew were arrested and were charged. They weren't charged, they were being accused. But the ship needed to be sold. And there were hundreds of thousands of euros for the process costs, which they needed to pay. But they, in the end, they could go free. So this is the situation we are in right now. There are people at court because they have saved people from drowning. Excuse me. This criminalization is not only about ships in the central Mediterranean, but also about ships which are like organizations trying to help in the eastern Mediterranean route. There is an NGO on Lesbos, which are at court because, again, charges of illegal immigrations and espionage, and again, very hard accusations. And a report by Human Rights Watch has been made. This help for illegal immigration, which they are being accused of, has happened on days where the people being accused weren't even in the country. So it's clearly a political process which is happening now. So about Lesbos and Turkey, where we are being active. In the end of 2015, beginning of 2016, over 500,000 humans reached Europe through Lesbos. And in response, the European Union reacted. In March 2016, there was a deal between Europe and Turkey where they closed the border. Everyone crossing the border after this date, which reached Greece, still have like very tough processes for their asylum is being decided. So there is processes which have been going on since 3 years and still haven't gotten asylum or a result about the process. So about this deal, there have been illegal pull and pushbacks on both sides of the borders. So if so, there have been cases where ships have already been in Greek waters and have been brought back to Turkey. And since this deal with Turkey, the island of Lesbos and other Greek islands are basically acting as a prison for the refugees stranded there. They aren't able to leave the islands. And for people who have been there since 3 years, that's a very frustrating process. It's a very sad process. The Camp Moria on Lesbos is the most gruesome place for refugees in Europe. Children are trying to kill themselves, and that's not even something abnormal there. And the mission here is to not have this, like, we want to act on behalf of this, and we want to bring this to attention to the media. So we are on this ship and we are reporting the situation this. And for us it is important that human rights are not being denied, that humans who have nothing in their lives besides their lives, that they at least continue to have their lives. This is why we are there on our ship.
I think I'm speaking for everyone and praising you. Thanks for all your work. Please continue like this. We have some questions in the room. There are 6 microphones. Have a short, concise question. No comments, please. Now there's your chance. Is there a question from the internet? Start with the internet. What is the worst that the EU is planning to make it harder for NGOs? That's the first question. That's hard to answer. I didn't know if it's the worst, but a lot of bad situations awaiting us by tripling the budget of Frontex. They are supposed to have more workers. Frontex is also operating in the Central Mediterranean, saved a few people, but it's still a border guard organization. And that's and the MICC Tripoli Act, meaning that people in international waters are just brought to Tripoli and said, there's no problem, it's not our deal. And structures that are very unstable there are in charge of people. Next microphone, please. Hello, thanks for all the information.
mein vorne.
Ach so.
To the front, please.
Ja, ach, erstmal vielen, vielen Dank für das, was ihr macht.
Thanks a lot for everything you're doing. A question. This flagging deal. I don't know how many ships are affected by this. If there's no country wanting to have a flag. We're trying to get a German flag. If no, why not? I mean, it's probably much more expensive than in Panama, but I think people would try to help there. Yeah, we can answer that pretty easily. States don't have to give flags to ships. So if the state doesn't want to do it out of political reasons, they don't do it. Next question from the internet. What is the best way to get better knowledge for all of this in the main medias? If we knew that, I think we would be much closer. I think the biggest thing is just make it aware that people are dying daily and every injustice are happening all the time. How? I don't really know. But like, talk to friends, family, your grandma, your grandpa, your aunt. Just that we remember in private. And like, stay informed and ask questions. Microphone in the front, please. Do you have an impression how the safety situation is with trade ships? Are they driving by because they don't want anything to do with this, or are they saving people? No, it's what's happening. People who got saved said that trade ships went by inside and just drove past, because the problem is these trade ships would be able to be processed in front of a court, and they don't want that because they could lose their ships. Most people who want to Europe, there is no legal way of reaching them, and that's a problem. Next, in the front, in the mid. You told us that Aquarius was 2 to 3 days on sea, and other ships even longer. How did the people survive all of this after 3 days without water? There was a confusion. The Aquarius was not allowed to reach port for multiple days. And of course, the Aquarius is a pretty big ship, 70 meters long. It has the capabilities to care for people. There is water, food. It's limited, of course. And it's still a hard trip for 7 days. And we need provisions after that. And we needed to divide them on 3 ships. So, it's no problem with delivering. Do they get in front of court as well? No, that's not really a problem.
So, die nächste Frage bitte auch von vorne Mitte.
Under which flag is the Mare Liberum? And are you afraid to be removed by this flag? So, our flag is German, it's Berlin. So our harbor is Berlin. The quick answer is yes. Yeah. Also institutions are trying that we will lose this flag, and this is coming from the Interior Ministry, that this pressure is going through these institutions.
Wir können eine letzte Frage.
No question from the internet, a question from the room in the back. One question is, how many ships are currently out at sea? Right now there is the Sea-Watch 3 with 33 refugees searching for a safe harbor. There is another ship with 200 people who have gotten a safe harbor, who are currently sailing to this port. And that's it for the ships which currently are on the central Mediterranean. That's it for the time. Thank you both for this very good talk. And yeah.